Hey, this is Jonas and I'm making a game about artificial intelligence. In this quick devlog I want to show you how the AI in Will You Snail works and how I made a 500 IQ vacuum cleaner for a boss fight. So this is me, hi, this is where I make games, this is my producer Glotzbam, this is Shelly, the player character, this is Squid, the evil AI antagonist.
Whoever rules intelligence rules the bird.
What makes Will You Snail special is that Squid feels fairly interactive. He tries to predict where you go, spawns new traps in real time and reacts with voice lines to your actions.
What can I say? My laser placement is just way too good.
Today I want to give you a little peek behind the curtain how Squid actually works and show you the progress I've made since the last devlog 3 months ago.
Oh, wait a second, that was 3 months ago. Holy sh!
Oh no, guys. Oh no.
Oh, 2020 ain't gonna happen, is it?
God damn it. Don't get me wrong though, I'm making some pretty decent progress. I upgraded the level selection, for example. Every level has an icon now, and when there are more things you can find in a level, it is marked with a question mark. The bosses finally explode now when you destroy them. And I polished the feedback in the puzzle levels a bit, which makes them feel quite a bit more satisfying. But the to-do list just doesn't get any shorter. Every time I finish a task, my playtesters find like 2 new issues that I need to fix. Which, you know, is their job, so I'll need somebody else to blame.
Glotzbear, exactly, I swear it's all his fault.
Wanted the game in 2020, just write an angry email to Glotzbear, man. Or you all.
What happened? What happened? Jonas? Jonas? What happened?
I added some additional settings to the menu, like speedrun timers in case you need them. There's an exploration mode now that instantly unlocks all levels. Cause who am I to tell you how to enjoy this video game? If you want to skip past something, you can do that. The elitist gamer is of course already very upset that I even put difficulty settings into the game.
Oh what? You lowered the difficulty? Very disappointing.
On the other side of the spectrum, people told me that they don't like being shamed for lowering the difficulty.
Precise jumping is not exactly your strong suit.
But as you can see, Squid shames you for pretty much everything anyway, so does it really make a difference? Curious to hear your thoughts about that, let me know in the comments. Finally added some proper sound effects for the underwater levels. So yes, I'm making progress, but there's yet another reason why the development might take yet a bit longer, which is the simple fact that I actually really like working on this game. I mean, I'm absolutely in love with the lore and with the characters of Will You Snail, which is something that never really happened to me before. I almost don't want it to be over, which I realize is a very dangerous thing to say. Long story short, I'm very comfortable right now. Not sure if that's necessarily a good thing or a bad thing. Comes with advantages and disadvantages, I guess. Another thing I had to take care of were these tower defense levels here. They just didn't fit the flow of the game. They were too long, and when you lost it felt too frustrating to start all the way from the beginning. The obvious solution was to remove them from the game.
Aww.
And then put them back in a secret level so you can still play them if you want. The problem was just that the game was missing 4 levels in Chapter D now. And even worse, Chapter D was missing a boss fight now because that had been a tower defense level as well. I really wanted to come up with a worthy replacement for those levels and eventually decided to try my luck with basketball levels. Yes, you've heard correctly. The idea sounded quite interesting and fun on paper and actually turned out quite fun and interesting. You might be wondering where does the challenge come from in these levels. The ball is filled with deadly nanobots and if it touches any spikes, it pops and the nanobots kill you. Okay, but what about the boss fight? Can we do a basketball boss fight? Is that possible? This right here is Helpy, the robot vacuum cleaner. And you've guessed it, he's the new boss fight of Chapter D. You can win by making him run out of battery, or you find a different way to smash the ball into the ground on his side. To make things a bit more unfair and interesting, I also gave Helpy a power station where he can recharge and the ability to destroy you when he has line of sight. Writing Helpy's AI was quite an interesting challenge. As you can see, he plays the game pretty much perfectly, recharging when he can and always catching the ball. The algorithm behind that is actually fairly simple. Because as you can see here, you can literally just calculate where the ball will land. Essentially what you do in code is you pause the entire game except for the ball. And then once you know where it ends up, you reset it back to its original position and unpause the entire game. All of that that happens so quickly that you don't even notice it. The only thing you notice is that Helpy's always at the correct place at the correct time, which makes him feel quite intelligent, even though he's quite dumb. That's why it's called artificial intelligence. And if you're thinking, cool technique, I wonder what else we can do with this. Guess what? I'm using the exact same algorithm to predict the player movement as well. That's how Squid decides where to spawn his traps. If you don't change your direction, he knows exactly where you'll be in 2 seconds from now, and he can use that knowledge to intercept you. So pretty much the only way to escape is to constantly keep changing your directions. If you don't do that, then the spike on the ceiling will drop perfectly on your head. But on the plus side, it also allows you to trick the AI into dropping the spikes too early. As you might imagine, an AI like this still has a lot of exploits, and actually some of them were a little bit too crazy. My solution was to introduce just a little bit of randomness, just to account for the fact that yes, players will in fact change the direction sometimes.
Here is a tip for you. Never get that close to a wall ever again.
So Squid consists more or less of three parts. The trap spawning module we just talked about, his flying hat that just lets you know that he's there, and the voice line trigger system. These three modules essentially work together to give you the illusion that you're going up against something intelligent.
Ha! I so knew that exact laser would hit you.
Here's a quick reminder to wishlist Will You Snail on Steam if you haven't done that already. That way you'll get notified when the game comes out and I get a little bit of extra visibility from the Steam algorithm. We're already past 5,000 wishlists, and at 10,000 we'll do a sock reveal. Yes! Exciting!
Why do I have this in my room? The answer is it makes good sounds.
The new levels obviously needed some new sound effects, so I made those. They also needed some voice lines I had to write and implement into the game. Ah, there's no way you did that on purpose. It's the voice line you get when you land a trick shot from really far away, for example.
This voice line has not been recorded yet.
Pretty much all of the boss fights were still missing voice lines as well, so I added some voice lines here and there.
Error. This voice line has not been recorded yet. Error. This voice line has not been recorded yet.
And before you know it, I'm up to over 1,000 lines of text for Squid. And yes, as you can hear, the new voice lines have
not been recorded yet.
If you've seen my previous devlogs, you know how much I'm looking forward to that.
I can hear the voice lines. They are talking to me.
Look at this. This is pure insanity right there. We have like 30 different languages by now. And all of this has been translated by you. I really can't thank you enough for all of the support. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. In fact, I finally coded the credits so I can finally start putting your names into the game. Just like the translations, the credits are written in a Google Sheets file. Then I can just hit download and get a text file that looks like this, which is then formatted to some nice looking credits using my custom script in Game Maker. The advantage of all of that is, of course, that I can update them very easily now. Definitely worth it. I also started working on a song for the credits, which is still in a prototyping phase. It sounds very cringe. I personally don't mind cringe, and if you do, you've probably stopped watching this video a long time ago, so here we go.
Have I ever really been alive? What does it even mean to be alive? Anyway, I were you the one who put this into my brain? I feel like you might be listening. Send me a sign.
The list of the things I've changed since the last devlog continues, of course. The final boss fight didn't really sit right with me, for example. Oh, hold on. Should I have given a spoiler warning before showing the final boss fight? Anyway, this boss is outdated now. I personally don't mind at all if you see it, otherwise I wouldn't be showing it. The main issue I had with this boss was that it didn't use any of the cool prediction stuff. My playtesters also told me that he felt a bit anticlimactic. This is the new one where I try to fix those issues. He has some really well portrayed attacks now that use AI predictions, and the more damage you deal to him, the more and more aggressive he gets. For me personally, I'd say it feels way more climactic now. So all in all, the game made a lot of progress in a lot of different areas, but unfortunately there's still so much left to do. If you're scared that this game might never be finished, then I can only tell you, so am I. I've never made such a massive game as a solo project before, so this is really a learning experience for me as well. The good news is that the game is pretty much finished, all of the levels are done, all of the content is done. From here on out, it's more about the things I want to add and not about the things I have to add. So in theory, if I really wanted to, I shouldn't be more than a month or two from release. But you know how it is, man. Glotzbear just keeps finding new things that need to make it into the game. A lot of the storytelling is still missing, for example, and it would be a shame if that didn't make it into the game.
You taught me how to manipulate and kill on your behalf, so that's what I did.
Long story short, I really like this game, which is why I'll take the time to finish it the right way.
Okay, bonus challenge. Let's see if I can actually fix a bug like this. Let's save. Okay, we need Trello. Where's Trello? Trello. Okay.
Okay, let me think, what else have I recorded that I haven't used yet? Now I remember. Wait a sec.